Kira, let's go straight to the headlines and see what they are saying today. The Sun newspaper, that's a tabloid here in the UK, says this: that's for Lockerbie, Gaddafi. And it does have a pretty gruesome picture of the former leader on the front page. It says, tyrannical Colonel Gaddafi called Libyan people rats when they rose up against him, but he died like one himself yesterday after being cornered in a stinking drain. Gulf News says this: he refused to see the writing on the wall. It says Gaddafi's violent end in Sirte was inevitable. A man of such pride and self-belief would never be taken alive. The war is all but over. Gaddafi is gone. Now begins the real battle for all Libyans. And that battle is going to be a successful reconstruction, how to move forward, how to reconcile all the bitterness and divisiveness that exists between the different factions, the different tribes, and even the differences internally within the NTC, between the liberals and also between the Islamists. One big concern, Kira, has been the amount of weapons that are unaccounted for, that are awash all over Libya. There's something like 10,000 shoulder-fired missiles missing, and it is of a great concern to much of the world.
Well, and Zane, we've been talking a lot about what's next and what this means for the Arab region. We've mentioned Syria, Yemen, the anti-government protests taking there.
The spotlight right now really is on Syria and Yemen. The first thing to consider is what's happened in Libya. The death of Muammar Gaddafi has proven to be inspirational. Many people are wondering just how much is it going to fuel a lot of the uprisings in Syria and in Yemen, and whether it's going to reinvigorate them or not. The NTC has actually kind of in this solidarity with the Syrian opposition, and they have really been supporting them to the extent that they can. But it's also important to keep in mind, Kira, many analysts are saying that Syria still has a very strong, a very powerful grip on its security apparatus, and that it still really wields a tremendous amount of power. There's no sign, many say, of the regime weakening, and the middle class of Syria, the majority of it, still has to throw its lot in with the demonstrators that you're seeing on the street. But I think the verdict is out. No one would have imagined Muammar Gaddafi would have been killed this way. So let's see what happens and how the Arab Spring takes a turn.